Today, I would like to explain about the Dhamma Chakka Pavattana Sutta. He said the emotion of the wheel of the Dhamma. Before our Dhamma talk, we should pay homage to the Buddha by reciting three times in a Mota Sutta.Namo dasa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhasa Namo dasa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhasa Namo dasa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhasa
今天禅师要开始转法轮经，在开始之前，大家先对世尊表示礼敬，念了三次南无大萨，那个意思是礼敬诸罗汉正等正觉者。
This sutta is the first discourse of the Buddha, which was given to the group of five monks.The sutta begins, Thus have I heard, on one occasion the Blessed One was dwelling in the deer park at Isipadana near Benares.
这部经是佛陀成道后所开示的第一部经，开示的对象是五比丘。经文开始说，如是我闻。一时世尊住在波罗奈附近仙人堕处的鹿野苑。
Here on one occasion means on the full moon day of June, July, nearly 2 months after the Buddha's enlightenment. At that time, the Buddha went from Buddhagaya to the Dhyabhaga at Isipadana. Here,Is means sage, Padana means to fall or land. Before our Bodhisattva became the enlightened one, there were many sages, especially many Pichika Buddhas, flying from the Himalayas to land there for Armstrong in Benares.After Armstrong, they flew back to the Himalayas from that deer park. That is why the place is called Isipadana, the landing place of sages.
这里经文所说的一时，是指佛陀成道之后将近两个月，在阳历六七月间的月圆日。那时佛陀从菩提迦耶来到仙人堕处的鹿野苑。为什么这个地方称为仙人堕处呢？因为在我们的菩萨成佛之前，有许多仙人，也就是隐士，住在喜马拉雅山，包括许多辟支佛在内。他们从居住的地方飞来，在鹿野苑降落下来，然后进入波罗奈城去托钵，托完钵之后又从鹿野苑起飞回到喜马拉雅山去，因此这个地方称为仙人堕处。
And so that continues. Then the Blessed One spoke to the group of five bhikkhus as follows. Bhikkhus,These two extremes should not be followed by one who has gone forth from the worldly life into homelessness. But do.
经文接着说，那时世尊对五比丘如此说，诸比丘，有两种极端是出家人所不应当从事的，是哪两种呢？
Here the five bhikkhus are Kundinya, Wabha, Badiya, Mahanama, and Asachi. Among them, Asaji was to become the teacher of Venerable Sariputta. All of them had fulfilled Paramis professions. 100,000 aeons ago, since the time of Vidhumudra Buddha, especially the brightest Vipassana Abdu, Sankharupaka Jnana stage, the inside knowledge of equanimity towards formations in previous Buddha's dispensations.
这里的五比丘是指焦成竹、卫拔、拔提迦、摩诃那摩以及阿梭氏，其中的阿梭氏比丘后来成为舍利佛尊者的老师。在十万大劫之前，他们都曾在圣莲花佛座下积聚波罗蜜，并且曾速度在过去诸佛的教化其中修行观禅，达到行舍智的阶段。
Why can we say that they had fulfilled Paramis professions? Because when they will begin Arahat, when they will begin Arahat after listening the discourse, another Lakana Sutta, they will suddenly begin Arahat and they will possess four analytical knowledges.
为什么我们能够说他们过去曾经积聚很多的波罗蜜呢？因为在他们最后这一生听闻佛陀讲解无我相经之后，他们就会证悟阿罗汉，同时也具足四无碍解智。
There are four analytical knowledges. Number one, Atta Bhadisambhita, the analytical knowledge of Dukkha Sitya, the noble truth of suffering. Number two, Dhamma Bhadisambhita, the analytical knowledge of Samudaya Sitya,the noble truth of the origin of suffering. Number three, Nirodhi Paticchasamutta, the analytical knowledge of the language and grammatical usage for the Dukkha Sitya Dhammas and Samudaya Sitya Dhammas. Number four,Padibhana Padisambhita, the analytical knowledge of the previous three analytical knowledge.
四无碍解智是第一，亦无碍解智，这是对苦谛的无碍解智。第二，法无碍解智，这是对极谛，也就是苦的原因，了解极地的无碍解智。第三，持无碍解智，这是对于苦地法以及极地法持与用法上的无碍解智。第四，应变无碍解智，这是对于前三种无碍解智的透彻了解，如此的无碍解智。
5 causes to attain 4 analytical knowledges. Number 1, adhigama, achievement. Achievement of arahatship or any noble path. Number 2, pariyadi, mastery of scriptures.Mastery of six scriptures means learning the three Pitakas by heart. Number three, Savana. Hearing the Dhamma carefully and respectfully. Number four, paripoccha. Questioning. Questioning means learning the commentaries and naughty points in Pali text. Number five, pubha yoga. Praya effort. Praya effort means he must have been practiced vipassana up to Sankharupaka jnana stage. The inside knowledge of equanimity towards formations in previous Buddha's dispensations. Among these five causes, number one is they must attain in this life. From number two to five, these four causes they must fulfill in previous Buddha's dispensations.
要得到事无碍解智，必须具备五项条件。第一项是证悟，意思就是说他们必须在那一生中证得阿罗汉果或其他三种当中任何一种圣道。第二个条件是要精通教理，意思就是他们必须背诵经律论三藏。第三个条件是闻法，也就是他们必须很细心地、很恭敬地听闻佛法。第四个条件是直问，就是他们必须研究三藏的注解，如此来清楚地了解三藏。第五个条件是先前的修行，意思就是他们必须在过去佛的教化期中曾经修行观禅，达到行舍智的阶段。这五项条件当中，第一项是今生得到的，也就是在他们得到事无碍解智那一生得到的，他们必须在那一生证得某一个圣道。从第二项到第五项这四个条件，这是在过去佛教化期中所累积所培育的。
So we should not forget that these five bhikkhus had fulfilled Paramis perfections in previous Buddha's dispensations to attain arhatship with four analytical knowledges.
所以我们不要忘记这项事实，也就是五比丘在过去佛的教化期中已经曾经累积波罗蜜，以便支持他们在最后那一生中能够证得阿罗汉果，连同事无碍解智。
So the sutta continues. One is devotion. There are two extremes. What two? One is devotion to the pleasures of sense. It is a low practice.Bhagha, a practice of worldlings, not a practice of noble ones, unbeneficial. The other is devotion to self-modification. It is painful, not a practice of noble ones, unbeneficial.
经文继续解释，佛陀所说的是哪两种极端？一种是沉迷于感官享乐，这是低下的、粗俗的、凡夫的行为，非圣者的行为，没有利益的；另一种是自我折磨的苦行，这是痛苦的、非圣者的行为，没有利益的。
Yeah, the Buddha says that one of the two extremesis devotion to the pleasures of sense. If a bhikkhu devotes himself to the pleasures of sense, his achievement to the sensual pleasures will increase day by day. Thus, he cannot realize nibbana or attain any other achievement in meditation.
佛陀说，两种极端当中的一种是沉迷于感官享乐。如果比丘沉迷于感官享乐， 那么他对欲乐的执着会日渐增强，因而无法证悟涅槃或达到其他禅修成果。
The other extreme is devotion to self-modification, such as laying on thongs, continuously standing on one leg. If a bhikkhu is devoted to self-modification, he cannot attain any deep concentration. Without deep concentration, he cannot realize the dhammas that means phenomena.As they really are. Therefore, he cannot penetrate the Four Noble Truths.
另一种极端是自我折磨的苦行，例如躺卧在刺上，持续地用一脚站立等等。如果比丘沉迷于自我折磨的苦行，他就无法培育深厚的定力。没有深厚的定力，就无法如实地了知诸法。因此无法彻悟四圣谛。
The Sutta continues, by avoiding these two extremes, the Tathagata has realized that middle path which gives vision, which gives understanding, which leads to calm, higher knowledge, enlightenment, Nibbana.
经文继续说道，借着避免这两种极端，如来实践中道，此中道带来彻见，带来真知，通向极境圣智正觉涅槃。
Yakam Upasma means the complete cessation of all defilements. Higher knowledge Vijnana means the knowledge which understands the Four Noble Truths.
这里所谓的极境是指完全灭除一切的烦恼，所谓圣智是指了悟四圣谛的智慧。
Here I would like to explain the importance of the Four Noble Truths.There is one sutta, Trigala Yuga Sutta. In that sutta, Buddha says thus, Bhikkhus, suppose a man will throw a yoke with a single hole into the great ocean, and there was a blind turtle which will come to the surface once every 100 years.What do you think, Bhikkhus? Would that blind turtle coming to the surface once every 100 years insert its neck into that yoke with a single hole?
在此，禅师想解释四圣谛的重要性。在相应部《二孔经》中，有一次佛陀问说：“诸比丘。”假设有人将中间有一个洞的二条丢入大海，而在茫茫大海中有一只瞎眼的海龟，每隔100年才浮出海面一次，你们认为如何，诸比丘？那只每隔100年才浮出海面一次的瞎眼海龟，会不会在浮出海面时将头伸入那二条中间的洞呢？
If it will ever do so, Venerable Sir, it will be only after a very long time.
朱比丘回答说，世尊，如果那只海龟要如此做到的话，那必然要经过很长久的时间才可能办到。
So now I shall hold that blind turtle coming to the surface once every 100 years, insert its neck into that yoke with a single hole, then the fool who has gone once to the nether world will regain the human state. For what reason? Because here, because there is no conduct guided by the Dhamma. No righteous conduct, no wholesome activity, no meritorious activity. Here there prevails mutual devouring, the devouring of the weak. For what reason? Because bhikkhus, they have not seen the four noble truths. What for? The noble truth of suffering, dukkha sicca, the noble truth of the origin of suffering, samudaya sicca, the noble truth of the cessation of suffering, nirodha sicca, and the noble truth of the way leading to the cessation of suffering, magga sicca.
佛陀接着说，那只每隔一百年才浮出海面一次的虾眼海龟，将头伸入那二条中间的洞，所需要的时间比鱼吃者堕入地狱之后要再投生到人间所需要的时间更短。什么缘故呢？诸比丘，因为鱼吃者的行为没有受到佛法引导，没有正当的行为，没有善行，没有德行，而是造了许多互相毁灭及毁灭弱者的业。为什么会如此呢？诸比丘，因为他们没有见到四圣地。何谓四圣地呢？也就是苦圣地、苦集圣地、苦灭圣地以及导致苦灭的道圣地。
Therefore, because an exertion should be made to understand. This is suffering, dukkha, sicca. An exertion should be made to understand. This is the origin of suffering, samudaya, sicca. An exertion should be made to understand. This is the cessation of suffering, nirodha, sicca. An exertion should be made to understand. This is the way leading to the cessation of suffering, magga sicca.
因此，诸比丘，应当精勤于了知，这是苦。应当精勤于了知，这是苦的原因。应当精勤于了知，这是苦的熄灭。应当精勤于了知，这是导致苦灭之道。
The middle path is the only way to attain the vision, the knowledge, and the enlightenment to realize Nirvana.
在本经《转法轮经》中所说的中道，是获得了悟涅槃的彻见、真知与正觉的唯一道路。
He said that continues. And because what is the middle path which gives vision, which gives understanding, which leads to come higher knowledge, enlightenment, nirvana?
转法轮经继续说道，诸比丘，那带来彻见，带来真知，通向极境圣智正觉涅槃的中道是什么呢？那就是八圣道分，即正见、正思维、正语、正业、正命、正精进、正念及正定。诸比丘，这就是带来彻见、带来真知、通向极境圣智正觉涅槃的中道。
It is this very noble eightfold path, namely, right view, right thinking, right speech, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness, and right concentration. Because this is that middle path which gives vision, which gives understanding, which leads to come higher knowledge, enlightenment, nirvana. Here I would like to explain the meaning of this passage. What is right view, Samadhiti. In the Mahasri Prana Sutta, the Buddha explains the four aspects of right view. Dukkha Jnana, Dukkha Samudaya Jnana, Dukkha Nirodha Jnana, Dukkha Nirodha Gamini Pratipadaya Jnana. Inside knowledge of Dukkha Sutta, the noble truth of suffering. The inside knowledge of Samudaya Sutta, the noble truth of the origin of suffering. The inside knowledge of Nirodha Sutta, the noble truth of the cessation of suffering. The inside knowledge of Magga Sutta, the noble truth of the path leading to the cessation of suffering. These four types of inside knowledge are called right view, samadhi.
在此，禅师要加以解释：什么是正见呢？在《大念处经》中，佛陀解释正见的四个层面如下：了知苦谛的智慧，了知极谛的智慧，了知灭谛的智慧，了知道谛的智慧。这四种智慧称为正见。
What is right thinking? Samasankappa. Application of the mind to the Dukkha Sutta. Application of the mind to the Samudaya Sutta. Application of the mind to the Nirodha Sutta. Application of the mind to the Magga Sutta. These four types of application of the mind are called right thinking.
什么是正思维呢？使心投入苦谛，使心投入极谛，使心投入灭谛，使心投入道谛。这四种使心投入的法称为正思维。
So right view, samadhi, and right thinking, samasankappa are always concomitant with each other.They can arise together in the same thought moment.
因此正见与正思维经常相伴存在，它们升起于同一个心事刹那中。
Right speech, samavacha, right action, samagamada, right livelihood, and right livelihood, samajiva are called sila trainingThe training in Bhaju.
正语、正业与正命属于戒学，也就是戒行的训练。
What is right effort? Sama Vayama. In Samatha meditation, the effort to concentrate on the Samatha object completely is right effort. In Vipassana meditation, the effort to realizeDukkha Sutta, Samudaya Sutta, Nirodha Sutta, and Magga Sutta is called right effort.
什么是正精进呢？修行止禅时，为了完全专注于止禅目标而付出的努力，称为正精进。修行观禅时，为了了知苦谛、极谛、灭谛与道谛。而付出的努力称为正精进。
What is right mindfulness, samasati? The mindfulness of Dukkha Sutta, the mindfulness of Samudaya Sutta, the mindfulness of Nirodha Sutta, and the mindfulness of Magga Sutta. These four types of mindfulness are called right mindfulness.
什么是正念呢？对苦谛的意念不忘，对极谛的意念不忘，对灭谛的意念不忘，以及对道谛的意念不忘，这四种意念不忘称为正念。
What is right concentration? Samadhi. In Samatha meditation, the eight attainments are called right concentration.Namely, first jhana, second jhana, third jhana, fourth jhana. The base of boundless space, the base of the boundless, the base of the boundless consciousness, the base of boundless, the base of nothingness, the base of neither perception nor non-perception.
什么是正定呢？在止禅中，八定称为正定。八定也就是初禅、第二禅、第三禅、第四禅，空无边处定、事无边处定、无所有处定，以及非想非非想处定。
There are two types of noble eightfold path, mundane and supra-mundane. In Vipassana meditation practice, there are also noble eightfold path. Number one, samadhi, application of the mind to the dukkha sitta dhamma.
有两种八圣道分，也就是世间的八圣道分以及出世间的八圣道分。就世间的八圣道分而言，在修行观禅的时候就有八圣道分存在。第一是正见，也就是了知苦谛法的智慧。
What is dukkha sitta?In brief or in short, five clinging aggregates are called dukkha sitta.
什么是苦谛呢？简单地说，五取蕴就是苦谛。
I would like to explain five clinging aggregates later.
之后禅师会解释五取蕴。
The inside knowledge of Samudaya Sitta, this is number two. Number one, Samadhi is the inside knowledge of Dukkha Sitta. Number two, inside knowledge is the inside knowledge of Samudaya Sitta.
刚才讲到正见有三种，有四种。第一种是了知苦谛的智慧，第二种是了知极谛的智慧。
What is the Samudaya Sitta? Samudaya Sitta means the origin of the Dukkha Sitta, especially the inside knowledge of dependent origination. It is called Samudaya Sitta.
什么是极谛呢？极谛是苦谛的因，尤其是缘起法，缘起法是极谛。
I would like to explain about the dependent origination later.
之后，禅师会再解释缘起法。
So these Dukkha Sitta Dhammas and Samudaya Sitta Dhammas are the object of Vipassana insight knowledge.
苦谛法与极谛法都是修行观禅的所缘目标。
Number three, Samadhi. The insight knowledge of the cessation of suffering.There are two types of cessation, mundane and supra-mundane.
第三种正见是了知灭谛的智慧。关于灭有两种，也就是世间的灭以及出世间的灭。
Mundane.Cessation means the momentary cessation of Dukkha Sitta Dhammas and Samudaya Sitta Dhammas. Dukkha Sijja Dhammas and Smudhiya Sijja Dhammas are called Sankharas, formations. Vipassana insight knowledge sees this cessation of these formations. This is momentary cessation. That insight knowledge is also called samadhi.
世间的灭是指苦谛法以及极谛法的刹那灭，也就是暂时的灭。苦谛法与极谛法又称为行法。观智可以照见到行法的刹那灭，这样的观智也是一种正见。
There is also another type of cessation called causal cessation. Causal cessation means because of the arising of cause, the effect arises. But because of the complete cessation of cause, the effect also ceases completely. This is also called causal rising and passing away.
另外一种世间的灭是因缘灭，所谓因缘灭就是因为由于因生起所以果生起，由于因完全坏灭所以果完全坏灭，这合起来是因缘的生灭。
The Right thinking, Sammasankappa, is always concomitant together with Sammadhiṭhi, right view. So, application of the mind to the Dukkha Sijja object, application of the mind to the Smudhiya Sijja object, and the application of the mind to the momentary and causal cessation of Dukkha Sijja Dhammas and Smudhiya Sijja Dhammas, orSankharas, formations. This is called mundane obligation of the mind to the object.
世间的正思维经常与世间的正见同时升起。世间的正思维也就是将心 投入苦谛，投入极谛，投入灭谛，投入道谛。
Before practicing samatha and vipassana, usually you observe precepts. These precepts are called right speech, samavacha, right action, samagamada, and right livelihood, samajiva. These are the training in bhaju. This is also mundane bhaju.
在你修行止观之前，必须先持守戒律。如此就是具备了正语、正业以及正命这三项圣道分。这三项是戒学，这是世间的戒。
In Vipassana meditation, the effort to realize Dukkha Sijja in Smudhiya Sijja is also called mundane effort.And again, the effort to realize the momentary and causal cessation of Dukkha Sijja in Smudhiya Sijja Dhammas is also called mundane effort.
在修行观禅的时候，为了了知苦谛与极谛而付出的努力，这是世间精进。然后进一步，为了观照苦谛法与极谛法的刹那灭与因缘灭所付出的努力也是世间精进。
The mindfulness of Dukkha Sijja Dhammas, the mindfulness of Smudhiya Sijja Dhammas, and the mindfulness of the momentary and causal rising and passing away of these Dukkha Sijja Dhammas and Smudhiya Sijja Dhammasis also called the mundane mindfulness, mundane right mindfulness, samasati.
对苦谛与极谛法的意念不忘，以及对苦谛与极谛法因缘生灭、刹那生灭的意念不忘，这些都是世间的正念。
Right concentration, sama samadhi. Jhana samadhis are also called right concentration, mundane right concentration. In the same way, when you are practicing vipassana, if you can concentrate the impermanent nature, suffering nature, and non-self nature of dukkha sijja dhammas and smurya sijja dhammas,This type of concentration is also called mundane concentration. That concentration always concomitant together with samadhi, right view.
Guan yu shi jian de zheng ding, chan na de jing li shi shi jian de zheng ding, zhe ge zai gang cai yi jing ti guo. Ran hou zai ni xiu xing guan chan de shi hou,你对于苦谛法与极谛法，他们无常、苦、无我这三项的专注，这个也是世间的正定。世间的正定，经常是与世间的正见同时存在。
They are also noble eightfold path, Subramandhi noble eightfold path.Number one, samadhi, the realization of nirvana object by path knowledge is called Subramandhi noble samadhi.
刚才所说的是世间的八正道分，接着要解释出世间的八正道分。第一是出世间的正见，也就是以道智了悟涅槃，这时候的智慧，这个道智是出世间的正见。
Application of the mind to the nirvana object is called right thinking, samasankappa.
使心投入涅槃，这样的法，这样的心所，这是正思维，出世间的正思维。
The noble path which realizes Nibbana destroys the defilements to commit the wrong speech, wrong action, and wrong livelihood. So right speech, right action, and right livelihood are present automatically when one realizes Nibbana.When realizes Nirvana,
圣道智能够灭除一切会导致违反正语、正业、正命的烦恼。因此，在一个人证悟涅槃的时候，正语、正业、正命这三项圣道分都同时存在。
Sama vayama right effort.The effort to realize Nirvana is called Samavayama, right effort. Right mindfulness, Samasati. The mindfulness of Nirodha Sijja, Nirvana object, is called right mindfulness, Samasati. Concentration on the Nirvana object is called right concentration, Samasamadhi.
出世间的正精进，就是为了了知涅槃所付出的努力。出世间的正念，就是对涅槃意念不忘。出世间的正定，就是专注于涅槃。
So, the Subramandhi Noble Eightfold Path always take Nirvana as object.
因此八，出世间的八圣道分。都是以涅槃作为他的所缘目标。
The Sutta continues. non-bhikkhus visits the noble truth of suffering. Birth is suffering, old age is suffering, sickness is suffering, death is suffering. Likewise, sorrow and grief, woe, lamentation and despair. To be bound to things or people we dislike. To be separated from things or people that we like. That also is suffering. Not to get what one wants. That also is suffering. In short, the five aggregates of clinging are suffering.
经文继续说道，诸比丘，这是苦圣地，生是苦，老是苦，病是苦，死是苦，愁悲苦忧恼都是苦，怨憎会是苦，爱别离是苦，求不得也是苦，简单地说，无取运是苦。
Here, but old age, sickness, and death are suffering according to conventional truth, Samudhi Sijja. To be born to things or people we like, we dislike, to be separated from things or people that we like and not to get what we want are Saraga Dukkha, which means the suffering that occurs because of attachment.
生老病死是苦，可以根据世俗地来了之。怨憎会、爱别离、求不得，称为有贪之苦，意思是因为执着而升起的苦。
Then the Buddha explains Dukkha Sijja in a brief way thus. In short, the five aggregates of clinging are suffering.They are the objects of insight knowledge.
然后佛陀以盖瓜的方式如此解释苦地，简单地说，五取运是苦，五取运都是观智的所缘目标。
What are the five aggregates of clinging? They are Rupa Khanda, Vedana Khanda,Rupa Badana Khanda, Vedana Badana Khanda, Sinyu Badana Khanda, Sankhara Badana Khanda, Vinyana Badana Khanda. Which means the clinging aggregate of materiality, the clinging aggregate of feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formation, the clinging aggregate of consciousness.What is the clinging aggregate of materiality? In Khanda Sutta of Khanda Vagga Sanyutta, Sanyutta 22.48, the Buddha taught Yanginchi Rupan Dita Nagata Bishopana Ija Dhamma Vedhamma Alari Gamma Sukumama Hinama Bani Dhamma Yandure Sandi Geva Sasam Ubadaniya Yahu Chati Rupu Badane Khandho.This is the explanation of the Buddha. What is the meaning? Whatever materiality there is, be it past, present, or future, internal or external, inferior or superior, subtle or gross, far or near, all these type of materiality that are the objects of clinging or grasping are called the clinging aggregate of materiality.In the same way, the Buddha explains the clinging aggregate of feeling, perception, formations, and consciousness. So you should understand that the past five aggregates of clinging are Dukkha Sijja. The present five aggregates of clinging are Dukkha Sijja. The future five aggregates of clinging are Dukkha Sijja. The internal five aggregates of clinging are Dukkha Sijja.The external five aggregates of clinging are Dukkha Sijja. The gross and subtle five aggregates of clinging are Dukkha Sijja. The inferior and superior five aggregates of clinging are Dukkha Sijja. The the five Indian five aggregates of Klingai are also Dukkha Sejja. So the Dukkha Sejja Dhammas, things pertaining to the truth of suffering, not only include the present five aggregates of Klingai, but also the past and the future five aggregates of Klingai. If a bhikkhu does not realize the Four Noble Truths, he cannot attain Nibbana. So if you want to attain Nibbana, you should try to realize the Four Noble Truths. Among the Four Noble Truths, Dukkha Sejja is one. Among Dukkha Sejja Dhammas, past, present, and future five aggregates of Klingai are all included. So if you want to escape from the round of rebirths, you should try to understand the past, present, and future five aggregates of Klingai.
什么是五取蕴呢？五取蕴就是色取蕴、受取蕴、想取蕴、行取蕴以及识取蕴。什么是色取蕴呢？在蕴品相应蕴经中，佛陀开示说，无论是过去的色法、未来的色法或现在的色法，内在的或外在的，粗的或细的，低劣的或高尚的，远的或近的色法，只要是会成为烦恼与执取的目标的色法，都称为色取蕴。佛陀以同样的方式解释受取蕴、想取蕴、行取蕴以及识取蕴。因此大家应当了解，不只是现在的五取蕴是苦地法而已，过去的、未来的、内在的、外在的、粗的、细的、低劣的、高尚的、远的以及近的五取蕴也都是苦地法。不了知四圣地，就无法证悟涅槃，而苦地正是四圣地当中的一项，它包括上述的十一种五取蕴。如果想要证悟涅槃，解脱生死轮回，就必须了知这些五取蕴。
The Sutta continues to explain the Second Noble Truth as follows. Now, because this is the Noble Truth of the origin of suffering, it is that craving that leads to further existence, along with the delight in the desire that delights here and there, namely the craving for sensual pleasure, the craving for existence, the craving for non-existence. Because such is the noble truth of the origin of suffering.
经文接着解释第二项圣地如下：诸比丘，这是苦集圣地，造成投生的是爱欲，它伴随着喜与贪同时升起，四处追求爱乐，也就是欲爱、有爱及非有爱。诸比丘，
The Buddha taught that craving is Smurya Sejja. In Nidanavaka Sanyutta, the Buddha taught that the dependent origination is also Smurya Sejja. So delusion, avijja, craving, tanha, clinging, upadana, formations, volitional formations, sankhara, karmic post karma are all Smurya Sejja. In short, all wholesome and unwholesome karmic process are Smurya Sejja. In Sejja Sanyutta, the Buddha taught in five ways. Number one, craving, tanha is Smurya Sejja. Number two, the ten defilements, greed, hatred, ignorance, conceit, wrong view, doubt, sloth, restlessness,
lack of moral shame, lack of moral dread are also smurya sijja. Number 3, all unwholesome states of gusala dhammas are smurya sijja. Number 4, all wholesome states in three wholesome, all unwholesome states in three wholesome roots, alobha, adosa, amoha, are smurya sijja. Number 5, all unwholesome in wholesome states or all wholesome in unwholesome karmic possess are also smurya sijja.
在本经中，佛陀教导说，爱欲是极地。然而，在因缘品相应中，佛陀教导说，缘起法也是极地。因此，无明、爱、取、行、业，都是极地。简单地说，一切善与不善业都是极地。在地相应中，佛陀以五种方式来解释极地。一、爱欲是极地。二、十种烦恼是极地。所谓十种烦恼，就是贪、嗔、痴、骄慢、邪见、疑、昏沉、吊举、无惭、无愧。三、一切不善法是极地。四、一切不善法与三善根是极地。所谓三善根，就是无贪、无嗔、无痴。五、一切善法与不善法，或者说一切善与不善的业力，也都是极地。
If all unwholesome and wholesome karmic possess as smurya sijja, then why did the Buddha teach in this sutta that craving is smurya sijja? If in the seed there is still potential, then someday the seed may grow roots. So too, the karmic possess concomitant together with craving can produce their results.Without craving, no karmic possess can produce any result. That is why the Buddha taught that craving is smurya sijja in this sutta.
既然一切的善与不善业力都是极地，那么为什么佛陀在本经中只说到爱欲是极地呢？举例而言，只要一颗种子中还有粘性，那么终有一天它就还会生根发芽。同样的，只要业力还有爱欲伴随，它就还会结成果报。如果没有了爱欲，业力就无法结成任何果报。这就是为什么佛陀说爱欲是极地的理由。
You should remember that smurya sijja is the origin of dukkha sijja. In this sutta, the Buddha taught dukkha sijja as follows. Sankhitina pinchupadanekhanda dukkha. In brief, the five aggregates of clinging are suffering. So smurya sijja is the origin of the five aggregates of clinging. You should remember this relationship between causes and effects.
大家应当记住，极地是苦的因。在本经中，佛陀如此教导。简单地说，无取蕴是苦，因此极地是无取蕴升起的原因。大家应当记住这种因果关系。
This dukkha sijja dhammas and smurya sijja dhammas are the object of vipassana, insight knowledge.If you want to try vipassana, then first you should try to know these dukkha sijja dhammas and smurya sijja dhammas. How you should try? I would like to explain tomorrow in detail. next time, not tomorrow.
前面禅师开示过的苦地法以及极地法都是修行观禅的目标，因此如果大家想要修行观禅，就必须先照见苦地法与极地法。如何才能照见呢？禅师将在下次开示中讲解。